Hey guys, ArtDude47 here, and today I wanted to do another unboxing video, again for something that's in my personal Nintendo collection, and again this is going to be a Japanese exclusive item that you may not have been aware of. Today, rather than a Game Boy Advance, I've got something from the Nintendo 64. This is a, again, Japanese exclusive Mario Kart that included a controller that was exclusive to Japan. The first thing to note about this is a pretty substantial box. It's pretty big in size. What I've got here is a copy of an American box that you might be familiar with for comparison. So I've got here Pokemon Stadium. This is the big box edition. It came with the transfer pack. This, if you compare the two boxes side by side, you can kind of see the Mario Kart is both a little bit taller over here, as well as wider, and it's deeper, so it's bigger than the American big box by a little bit on each side. Now, just going throughout the box here, on the front we've got some pretty good box art, Mario on his cart, the big pop-out letters, you know, showing that it's including this controller in big letters, and then I also like that there's just a little cart there on the side. Of course, most of this is in Japanese. However, it is funny to note that a lot of times in the Japanese systems, there is some English mixed throughout, so like Mario Kart 64, obviously, but the character names, which I'm not sure if you can make out, it's got Luigi, Donkey Kong, Koopa, Wario, Mario, and Canopio, I believe is how you say it. That's actually Toad in the Japanese market. So on the side here, we've just got a picture here, again showing the controller, and then a screen cap or a picture showing Mario Kart. The back just has your standard information about the game, shows that it can be played four players, barcode, all of that that you would normally see on the box. Other side has a different screen cap, this time of the train level, and of course still showing the controller. Bottom's got nothing here, and then the top just has the Mario Kart logo. So now, cracking into this, let's get this open here. You'll see on the inside of the box it's split into two compartments. Here we've got a normal sized game box, so this is just the standard box that Mario Kart would have come in. The Japanese size is very similar to the North American released games. So again, same box art, just the logos on all sides and the same art there. Now, dissimilar to the American releases, the Japanese releases actually came out on cardboard, or rather than cardboard, excuse me, they came in a plastic tray. So let me remove the manuals that came with it, and you will see it comes in this plastic tray. Now I've got it upside down here, but the plastic says Nintendo 64 on it. It's etched in there, and then the game cartridge, unlike the American release, it looks the same to the box for the Japanese release. Now also with this, I've got a few different information booklets. This one seems to be detailing the controls for the game. Let me try to get that all on screen for you. So it kind of goes over what each button will do. And then on the back here, we've got information on all of the items that are in the game. So that's pretty cool. Now the second insert I've got that came with it here, so this one, I just now realized, I don't think was supposed to come with this. This looks like to be the same type of thing, a control guide. But looking on the back here, this is actually for Smash Bros. So I'm wondering if that was accidentally included in my box, or maybe if it came as a promotion for Smash Bros. But it definitely talks about controls for Smash Bros. Now, moving on, we've just got the game manual for Mario Kart 64, which I won't go through the whole manual, but you know, it's got your basic game information, everything you might want to know. There's some course information some item information, things like that. Now for the part that makes this actually really interesting is the controller that was included. Because this controller could not be gotten outside of Japan, this was not one that was released in America. Let me just unwrap the cord so you can see here. It wasn't released in Europe either. Now the top is just the standard black that was released in America. Mine's actually a little dusty from being in that box. I've got multiple controllers, so this one actually doesn't get used that often. Let me just clear some of that off. So this one is the standard black, but the bottom, it's a two-tone controller, almost like the Pikachu controller that did come out in America, is standard gray. So it's split in half by color. And yes, these can be faked, obviously. So the one way to make sure you're getting it is buying it boxed. Because then, even if it's faked, at least you've got the box proving this was a real thing. And now, I will show the box one more time, just so you could take note. If you look at the controller image here, you could see it's definitely supposed to be both black and gray. So, that was included in the game. And then another important thing to note, just if anybody was questioning it, there's absolutely 100% no difference between other region controllers and Japanese controllers. So if you want to use this on a PAL or North American game, Nintendo 64 system, you can do that without any problems. So, you know, this is something that you could definitely get and use. As far as price, this is actually not very rare. You can get this game with the box, with the controller, for about $50 on eBay. So it is something, and that's shipped normally, $50, no additional postage. So if it's something you're interested in, I would definitely encourage you to check it out. Adds another controller, and it's just something interesting that you wouldn't have seen growing up. Alright guys, so I think that's all I wanted to talk about in this episode. I do thank you for watching. Please leave a thumbs up. Just really helps the channel. Share the video with your friends, whatever you want to do, and consider subscribing for more content.